In this video, we'll learn how to save an Excel workbook which contains the macro part. So if you have seen the previous video, we have recorded macro where we can do the formatting part. Okay, now the macro contains, now the file contains some macro. If I want to save this file, how do I save it? So first of all, it will not be saved by .xlsx version. Okay, you have to save by some other extension. So let us see that. I have recorded a macro and I just want to save that macro. So once I click on that place, once I click on the save file, I'll get this kind of a message. What does this message say is, you cannot save a file which contains a macro, simply macro theory workbook. You need to select something else. So you can see here, the following features cannot be saved in a macro free workbook. Okay. So what you have to do is, to save this file with these features, click no. If you want to save this macro file with these features, click no. And then choose a macro enabled file in this file type list. So I'll just click on this no part, okay, and what I'll do is, the name is given as Excel VBA, but I don't want to use this Excel workbook, that's a type given as Excel workbook. I want to select some other type, so I'll just click on this save as type, and I'll click on Excel macro enabled workbook. So now my Excel file is Excel VBA and Excel macro enabled workbook. Remember, the extension is .xlsm, okay, so I'll just click on this save. Okay, now the file is saved. I'll show you the place where it is saved now. I'll just go back to that folder. I'll open this folder again. Okay, now this is the file. This is Excel VBA, that's a file without the macros, and this one is with the macros. If you see, there's a slight difference in the after the name, the names are same, but if you see, that's the icon given as for the macro enabled workbook. Okay, extension is .xlsm for this one. .xlsx for this version itself, right? So I'll just go back to my file, which is this given here, right? So I hope you're able to understand how do we save a macro workbook, okay, the file which contains some macros, okay, with this macro enabled workbook type, right? That's all for this video.